Once upon a time, there was a boy named Peter. He and his grandfather lived in a cottage with a garden surrounded by a high stone wall. Outside, there was a great meadow, and beyond the meadow, a deep, dark forest. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. On the branch of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. "All is quiet," chirped the bird gaily. Just then, a duck came waddling around. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Duck. The little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to her, and shrugged his shoulders. "What kind of bird are you if you can't fly?" said the bird. To this, the duck replied, "What kind of bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Thank you. Something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling across the grass. The cat thought, the bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him. Stealthily, he crept toward the bird on his velvet paws. Look out! Shouted Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the safety of the middle of the pond, the cat walked around the tree and thought, is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away. Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone to the meadow. It is a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, what would you do then? Attention to his father's words. Boys like Peter are simply not afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand, locked the gate, and led him home. Had Peter gone, then a big gray wolf came out of the forest.
Thank you.
In a twinkling, the cat climbed up the tree. The duck quacked, and in her excitement, foolishly jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer and nearer, catching up with her. Then he got her, and with one gulp, swallowed her. And now, this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another. But not too close to the cat. And the wolf walked around and around the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes. In the meantime, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. He wasn't at all afraid. He ran home, took a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Peter Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." While the wolf snapped at him again and again and again. He was very angry. The bird did worry the wolf, and how the wolf wanted to catch him. But the bird was cleverer, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down, caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. Jumping only made the rope around his tail tighter. Out of the woods came the hunters. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they went. Peter, Bertie and I have already caught the wolf. And now, you should help us take him to the zoo. Imagine the triumphant procession. Peter at the head. Grandfather tossed his head discontentedly. Well, what if Peter hadn't caught the wolf? What would have happened then? Listen very carefully. You can hear the duck quacking inside the wolf. Because the wolf, in his hurry, and with a fortunate lack of decorum, had swallowed her alive.